So now that we have a working asset manager, it's probably worth taking a step back and talking about how good asset loading works in good games. See, proper asset loading means you need to take into account how a user is going to experience your game and benefit from that properly. So for instance, if you are on a CD-ROM drive, you have to know that it's going to take a certain amount of time to actually stream data from the disk into memory. So you have to pretty much cover that by doing some 3-second animation or something else to hide from the user that streaming overhead. Now, some very interesting examples of this come to mind. The first is probably one of the more famous ones, Devil May Cry, back on the original PlayStation 2. This game had a really cool mode that while the scene was actually loading, if you did your button smashing, you'd actually do damage to the loading bar. I actually remember sitting in my room watching my roommate kind of smash on this button controller as mad as possible because he was so angry that it was taking so long to load. But by the time the level actually loaded, he was happy again and could go on killing all sorts of demons. The second example that comes to mind is actually Metroid Prime for the GameCube. This was actually a simplistic tunnel shooter. Effectively, you had segments of geometry that your player would move through over time. They did something really cool, is that they only allowed one section of tunnel in memory at a time. This meant that each tunnel could be super high resolution graphics because there was nothing else competing for space. As you moved towards the end of a tunnel though, towards one of those little doors you gotta shoot to open, it would start streaming in the next level. The problem with this though was if you started running too fast, you would get to the door before the streaming was done. You'd sit there shooting the door and it wouldn't open yet because the next level hadn't loaded. My personal favorite is actually Jack and Daxter. These guys had probably one of the earliest streaming mechanisms that I ever found, and the coolest way to hide it too. They had an infinite terrain so you could run around and do all sorts of stuff, but if you, for some reason, were able to move fast enough that you were moving in an area that the terrain hadn't been streamed off of disk yet, they'd trip your player. This is the only time in the entire game where your player would actually fall down and then play a 3 to 4 second get up animation. Of course, during that time, they had plenty of extra space to spin up the rest of the data from the disk. The point is this, most of game development is smoke and mirrors, so take advantage of that to give your user a believable experience.